Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Russell Temple CME Church, located at 507 North Alfred Street in Alexandria, Virginia. We're glad you stopped by today, and we thank you and welcome you, and thank you for joining us today. Our first on service is Music Ministry, Love Lifted Up. Second thing we have is invocation by Brother George Hardy. And then we have scripture by Sister Tiffany Carey. We thank you for joining us today. Sit back, enjoy the service, and you could be anywhere else, but you decided to be at Russell Temple. Sit back and enjoy the Lord. Enjoy the service. We love you. Give God some glory, everybody. Give God some praise. Hallelujah, Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made. Music ministry. Amen.
Today, I Hymn of Praise is going to be Lift Him Up, page 411 in your hymnals. You know the words. Sing along with us.
Good morning. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come giving you thanks and praise for this day. Lord, we pray that as you come down, we look up to you. Open our eyes. Open our mind. Open our heart, Lord, that we might be able to receive the blessing that you have for us this day. Bless the speaker of the hour. Bless all the participants. And Father God, we pray that you will bless each and every member and those outside of Russell Temple that are listening on. Bless each one of them also. These and other blessings we ask through your son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Good afternoon. I'll read Psalms 103, verses 1 through 8. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases. Who forgiveth, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executeth righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known his ways unto Moses, his acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, plenteous in mercy. Thank you.
Next, we will have the Ministry of Music. Thank you.
Good afternoon, church. The Lord has done great things for us. In Psalms 126, it says, when the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, we were like those who dreamed. Our mouths were filled with laughter. Our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. How many great things has God done for you? We were blessed by that song, everybody. Give God some praise. Give God some glory. He's been a wonderful. He's done great things in your life. Think about the great things that you've been going through. That song just blessed me to high heavens. Hallelujah. God is doing great things. Next, we will have a board member from our steward board will come to us. And then we have a song by the music ministry. And then we have our amazing, phenomenal pastor will come forth and bring forth the wonderful word, Reverend, Elder, Pastor, Elder, Justice, Agee, Kevin Agee. You be ready for the word. Sit back, enjoy. Hallelujah, y'all. Hallelujah. Amen.
Good afternoon, family and friends. It is now offering time. It's the time when we can give back a portion of all that God has given us. Please notate on your envelope if you're giving to a special cause, okay? As you are aware, we have several ways to give: online, Giblify, cash, and PayPal. You can also mail it to the church, Russell Temple CME Church, 507 North Alfred Street, Alexandria, Virginia, 22314. Or you can drop it off at the church. And last of all, you can contact one of the names on that list in the last line, and they will be glad to assist you. Have a blessed week.
Hallelujah. The Lord is blessing me right now. Right now, he woke me up this morning and started me on my way. The Lord is blessing me right now. He woke me up this morning. I was clothed in my right mind. He didn't let me sleep too late. He woke me right on time. He woke me up this morning and started me on my way. The Lord is blessing me right now. Come on, y'all ought to give God some praise. Amen. Is the Lord blessing you right now? Hallelujah. I know the Lord is blessing me right now. Amen. God is an awesome God. Amen. Greetings, my beloved, in Jesus' joy. What a blessing, what a privilege it is to be able to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth just one more time. Amen. You heard our lectionary reading by Sister Tiffany Carey from the 103rd Psalm, verses 1 through 8. In verses 1 and 2, the New Revised Standard Version, these are the words of the psalmist. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and do not forget all his benefits. Amen. Some translations read, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Hallelujah. This afternoon, my beloved brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, I want to share with you just for a few moments from the thought, a divine benefit plan. A divine benefit plan. Amen. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. He has great things. He has done great things. He has done great things. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord, by the power of grace divine. Let my soul look up with a steadfast hope and my will be lost in thine. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Now may the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be accepted in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. A divine benefit plan. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and do not forget all his benefits. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. I'm struck by the use of the word benefits. The Hebrew word that is translated benefits in English in Psalm 103, verse 2, that Hebrew word means dealing. It means recompense, which is a name for repayment or reward. It also means dessert, not dessert like the type that helps me stay overweight, but dessert in terms of what you deserve, as in your just dessert or your right dessert. It also means deserving, or treatment, or reward. That is the Hebrew word that is translated benefit in Psalm 103, verse 2. The Hebrew word is gemulah. Gemulah is the Hebrew word. That Hebrew word is actually derived from the word gamal, which is the Hebrew word for camel. And I don't know a lot about, I'm a city guy, so I don't know a whole lot about animals, but what I do know about camels is that camels work hard. Amen. Camels labor. Isn't that right? And it's interesting that the psalmist uses this particular word, benefits, derived from a Hebrew word, which means camel. And you think about the word being defined as something that is a dessert or something that's deserving, something that is repayment or recompense or reward. And we are reminded, beloved, that when we work, we expect a reward. Isn't that right? As a matter of fact, here we are a week shy of the anniversary of the 59th anniversary of the March on Washington. And while we, you know, get caught up in the beauty and the eloquence of the I Have a Dream speech, and that certainly is a beautiful vision for all of humanity, sometimes in terms of the historical significance, we have a tendency to forget that when Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and the leaders of the civil rights movement got together. They were working in concert with Asa Philip Randolph of the Pullman Porters Union and all of the labor unions. Basically, that was actually a march. The March on Washington was actually a march for economic empowerment and economic opportunity. And even as we think in a contemporary era, in many instances, one of the main reasons why we have some of the problems that we have, aside from the fact that people are dealing with the sin and the demon of greed, you know, people are dealing with the sin and the demon of temptation. And by falling into temptation, you know, folk are greedy. So that some folk try to hoard everything and others are left without. But when you think about it from a human point of view, one of the main reasons why we have so many people that go to work every day, maybe even have two or three jobs and are still in poverty, is because those folk in their workplaces do not have a benefit plan. Isn't that right? Sometimes you go and you make whatever the hourly wage is, but the fact of the matter is, sometimes even if you make what some folk would consider to be a good hourly wage or a good weekly salary or a good monthly or annual salary, the fact of the matter is, if you don't have a good benefit package to go with that salary, you're in trouble. Isn't that right? Even if you make what some folk would consider to be a good salary in terms of the dollar amount, for example, if you don't have a good health insurance plan as a part of your benefit package, you're still in trouble. Isn't that right? And even as we live in a day and time when people are living to be older than they ever have in modern human history, the fact of the matter is, if a good pension plan or retirement plan is not a part of your benefit plan, you are in fact in trouble. Isn't that right? Matter of fact, just yesterday, Lady Agee and I, we attended the funeral and we had a brief conversation with a former parishioner who has become a family friend. And this particular former parishioner and family friend was talking about making a change in employment. And even though the company with whom this friend, you know, signed the employment agreement, even though the salary is just a little bit less than what that person is making right now, the fact of the matter is, one of the things aside from, you know, mental health and inner peace, not only did those things draw this friend to take that new job, that new position, but the fact of the matter is, the benefit plan, the benefit package made it well worth it, because it was even more valuable than what's being received in the contemporary workplace. But my brothers and my sisters, when you talk about serving the Lord, there's a divine benefit plan. Isn't that right? The Lord knows that we need certain things in order to subsist. Isn't that right? The Lord knows that we need food and clothing and housing. Isn't that right? He knows that we need adequate education. He knows that we need retirement benefits and a pension plan and that type of thing. But as we look to the psalmist in Psalm 103 and we think about the divine benefit plan, when we think about the benefit plan that comes from having faith in God, when we think of the benefit plan that comes from serving the Lord, when you live a life of faith, you indeed have a divine benefit plan. And the fact of the matter is, my brothers and my sisters, if we want to break down God's divine benefit plan, I could stay here all the rest of the afternoon and all the rest of the evening and still could not find adequate words to fully describe God's benefit plan. And even if you look here in the 103rd Psalm, and we're just going to stick to the text this afternoon, but just between verses 3 through 8 and Psalm 103, you see multiple components to God's divine benefit plan. You see that serving God indeed comes with a divine benefit plan. So as we look to the words of the psalmist in Psalm 103, and we think about God's divine benefit plan, let me share just a few things with you that are part of God's divine benefit plan, and we'll let you go about your afternoon. The first thing I want to share with you, my brothers and my sisters, is that God's divine benefit plan includes forgiveness. Isn't that right? Did not the psalmist say that God forgives all of our iniquity? Aren't you glad that God has promised to forgive all your iniquity? Aren't you glad that the word of God says that if we confess our sins, that God is faithful and just to forgive us of all of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness? Aren't you grateful that Jesus thought it not robbery to shed his precious blood for the pardon and remission of our sins and the sins of the whole world? Aren't you glad this afternoon that God's divine benefit plan includes forgiveness? But not only does the plan include forgiveness, God's divine benefit plan includes healing. Isn't that right? In verse 3, the psalmist said that the Lord heals all our diseases. Isn't that right? God heals all of our bodies, minds, and souls' diseases. Isn't that right? Does not the Negro spiritual say there is a balm in Gilead that makes the wounded whole? There is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. Didn't the old hymn writer say, there's not a friend like the lowly Jesus? No, not one. No, not one. None else can heal all our soul's diseases. No, not one. no, not one. Isn't it good to know that the Lord can not only heal your body's diseases, but the Lord can heal your mind's and your soul's diseases as well. Not only does the benefit plan include forgiveness and healing, but God's divine benefit plan includes redemption. Aren't you glad for redemption? In verse 4 of Psalm 103, the word says that the Lord redeems our lives from the pit. Hallelujah. Isn't it good to know that you have, in fact, been redeemed? Did not the songwriter say, I am redeemed, bought with a price? Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody asks you just who I am, tell them I am redeemed. And not only are we just redeemed, and often we're redeemed from physical danger, we're redeemed from spiritual damnation and destruction, isn't that right? But in that same breath, not only is God's divine benefit plan inclusive of forgiveness, healing, and redemption, but God's divine benefit plan includes life. Notice the psalmist said, he redeems your life from the pit. Now, the pit means the grave, isn't that right? That means that the Lord delivers us from death. We've been looking at the book of Revelation in the church school lesson series over the past few weeks. And there's a phrase in the book of Revelation called the second death. Isn't that right? The Bible says that it is appointed to every human being one time to die. Isn't that right? That means that most likely, if we are not alive, because we don't know when Jesus is coming again. So assuming that we will not necessarily be alive when Jesus comes again in his glory to judge both the living and the dead. Now, we don't know whether we will be or we won't be, because nobody knows when that time is coming. But the fact of the matter is, unless we are among those who are alive when Jesus comes again in glory to judge the living and the dead, one day we will all die. But the fact of the matter is, that's the last time and the only time that we'll die. The good news is that if we have faith in our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ, we will not have to die what the book of Revelation calls the second death. We won't have to worry about our souls going to hell. We won't have to worry about having to spend eternity with the devil. Hallelujah. God, in fact, promises to give us life. That's why in the parable that Jesus shared in the gospel according to St. John chapter 10, when he describes himself as not only the door and the gate of the sheep, but he also described himself as the good shepherd. That's why in John chapter 10 and verse 10, Jesus said, I come that they might have life and have it more abundantly. God promised us abundant life on this side of glory, but he also promised us abundant life throughout eternity in the kingdom of God, in the presence of God, in the presence of Christ, in the kingdom of heaven. Yes, my beloved, God's divine benefit plan includes forgiveness and healing and redemption and life. But along that line, his divine benefit plan also includes love. Did you not hear the beautiful hymn of the church, you know, singing about love? Isn't that right? The fact of the matter is, my brothers and my sisters, Jesus loves us all unconditionally. Isn't that right? The hymn writer said, I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within. I was sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry, and from the waters lifted me. Now safe am I. Love lifted me, love lifted me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Aren't you glad that God has that unconditional love for us? Aren't you glad that God demonstrated that love for us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us? That is the greatest act of love ever shown. Isn't that right? The Bible says in 1 John chapter 3 and verse 16, by this we know love, that he laid down his life for us, and we also ought to lay down our lives for our brothers and our sisters. Aren't you glad this afternoon that God has unconditional love for you and for me? Aren't you glad that God has steadfast love? The psalmist said, his steadfast love endures forever. Another word for the phrase steadfast love is mercy. Amen. We'll talk about mercy in a minute. Isn't that right? But not only does God's divine benefit plan include forgiveness, healing, redemption, life, and love, it also includes provision. Isn't that right? Aren't you grateful that God provides? In verse 5, the Bible says that the Lord satisfies you with good as long as you live. That means that God will provide everything that we need. Isn't that right? In the old hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness, the hymn writer said, oh, I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Isn't that right? In the modern contemporary gospel song, based upon the beginning of Psalm 23, safe in his arms, the songwriter said, because the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything I need. Aren't you glad that you have everything you need this afternoon? Aren't you grateful that the Lord provides everything that you need to make it from day to day? But not only does the divine benefit plan include forgiveness and healing and redemption and life and love and provision, the Lord's divine benefit plan also includes renewal. Somebody ought to shout renewal. It says in verse 5, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Every now and then, we all need renewal. Isn't that right? Every now and then, we all get a little tired. Isn't that right? Every now and then, we all get a little bit weak. Isn't that right? Every now and then, we all get a little bit discouraged. Isn't that right? Every now and then, we all get a little bit despondent. Isn't that right? Every now and then, we all need to be renewed. Isn't that right? Aren't you grateful that you serve a God who is willing to renew your physical, your mental, your emotional, and your spiritual strength? Isn't that right? Did not the prophet Isaiah say that they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength? They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Not only does God's divine benefit plan include forgiveness and healing and redemption and life and love and provision and renewal, but the Lord's divine benefit plan also includes revelation. Oh, hallelujah, revelation. Every now and then, we need God to make known his plan to us. Isn't that right? Every now and then, we need the Lord to show us a little bit of what he wants us to do and what he has in store for us. Isn't that right? Every now and then, the Lord will reveal some things to us. In verse 7, the psalmist said that he made known his ways to Moses, his acts to the people of Israel. And just like the Lord made things known to Moses and the people of Israel, every now and then the Lord makes things known to us. Isn't that right? Sometimes the Lord makes things known to the prophets. Sometimes the Lord makes things known to the preachers and teachers. Sometimes the Lord makes things known to the pastors. And every now and then the Lord makes things known to us. Isn't that right? And even if he does not make them known by speaking to us directly, sometimes he makes things known by using others as instruments of his divine revelation. Every now and then, he makes things known to us through the power of his word. Isn't that right? That's why we read the word. That's why we study the word. That's why we listen to the word. God has all types of ways of revealing God's self to us. And we who are traditional Christians, we believe that God revealed himself to human beings in the person of his only begotten Son, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. And he also revealed himself to us in the person of the Holy Spirit, Father, Son, Holy Ghost, God in three persons, the Blessed Trinity. Not only does God's divine benefit plan include forgiveness and healing and redemption and life and love and provision and renewal and revelation, but my brothers and my sisters, God's divine benefit plan also includes justice. Amen. The fact of the matter is, my brothers and my sisters, God's divine benefit plan includes justice. Isn't that right? My brothers and my sisters, the word of the Lord reminds us that the Lord works vindication and justice for all who are oppressed. Isn't that right? Aren't you glad that God is a God of justice? Aren't you glad that God is a God of the oppressed? Aren't you glad that God is a God who liberates the oppressed? Aren't you glad that God is a God who sets captives free? Aren't you glad that God is a God who vindicates his people? Aren't you glad that God is a God of justice, just as he is a God of love and compassion? Yes, my brothers and my sisters, God is indeed a God of justice. But last but not least, my brothers and my sisters, not only does God's divine benefit plan include forgiveness and healing and redemption and life and love and provision and renewal and revelation and justice and vindication, but last but not least, God's divine benefit plan includes grace and mercy. Aren't you grateful for grace and mercy? Yes, my beloved, the psalmist reminds us in this beautiful psalm, he says, the Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, which also means compassion. Aren't you glad, my brothers and my sisters, that even though this word benefits means deserving, aren't you glad that we don't always get everything we deserve? For all of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Aren't you grateful that we don't always get all the punishment we deserve? Aren't you glad that we don't pay all the penalties that we deserve to pay? Not only that, but every now and then the Lord will give us some blessings that we don't deserve. Aren't you glad that every now and then we get some good things that we don't deserve? Aren't you glad that every now and then the Lord gives us some benefits that we don't deserve? Aren't you glad that the Lord has a divine benefit plan that has enough benefits for everybody in all creation? You don't have to worry about whether the company's budget is big enough. You don't have to worry about whether the government's budget is big enough. You don't have to worry about what the stock market is doing and what bonds are doing. The fact of the matter is, in the divine benefit plan, the Lord has enough benefits for all of us to have everything that we need materially and physically and spiritually. God is an awesome God. You ought to give God some praise for his benefit plan. Oh, the songwriter had the right idea when he penned the words, when I think of all the good things that are happening to me, I got legs to walk, ears to hear, and eyes to see. Lord, isn't that good news, my beloved brothers and sisters? When I think of all the good things that come my way, it must be Jesus looking out for me. He is always looking out for me, always busy opening doors that I can't even see. I don't have to worry because he takes good care of me. It's Jesus looking out for me. Give God some hallelujah praise for a divine benefit plan.
Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah. With his blood, he has saved me. With his power, he has raised me. To God be the glory for the things he has done. This, beloved, is an opportunity for anyone who would like to commit his or her life to Jesus Christ our Lord. We cannot do enough to deserve that gift, but Jesus already paid the price for us. With his blood, he has saved you. With his power, he has raised you. That's good news. If there is one who is not absolutely certain this afternoon that your sins are forgiven and your soul is saved, it's really, really simple. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you will be saved. It's just that simple, my friends. If there's anyone watching or listening this afternoon who is not absolutely certain, this is your opportunity to publicly confess and profess that you believe, amen, you believe that Jesus is who the Word says Jesus is. This is your opportunity to profess that you believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. If you want to make that public profession of faith this afternoon, you may do it one of a number of ways. You can unmute and express your desire verbally. You can type a public or private message in the chat if you're watching on Zoom today. For that matter, those who might watch it on Facebook or YouTube, you can put a message in the comment section on there too, and we'll make sure we reply to you. If you want to call the pastor directly, maybe you don't want to say everything in front of everybody. That's all right. As long as you make a profession to another human being, you can call or text me on my personal cell phone number, 201-736-9107. Those who are watching or the Zoom, it's in the chat right now. Or you can send me a private message on the social medium of your choice. I'm on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and Twitter. On Facebook, LinkedIn, and Instagram, I'm just Kevin Agee. I think Instagram is Kevin.Agee, but it's just my first and last name. It's real simple. On Twitter, my handle is Preaching Turf. Amen. Feel free, my beloved, to reach out, and we'll be happy to confirm your profession of faith and receive you into the kingdom of God. If there's anyone who is already a part of the body of Christ, already a part of the kingdom of God, already a part of the church, who would like to recommit or rededicate your life to the Lord, we invite you to do that at this time too. Same means, any of the same means that I just outlined, you can do that. Last but not least, if anybody is watching or listening who is in need of a church home, we would love to have you and cordially invite you to join us here at Russell Temple. Amen. Even though we're still worshiping virtually until we get a few more things fixed up in the building, make no mistake about it, beloved, the doors of the church still stand wide open on the hinges of welcome. We would love to have you as a part of our branch of God's family tree. Not a perfect church, just because there are no perfect people except our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ himself. But we are a loving church, a caring church, a genuine church, a Bible-believing and teaching church, and we would love to have you as a part of your family. Beloved, even in this environment, as we continue to worship virtually and electronically, the doors of the church stand wide open on the hinges of welcome. Is there one this afternoon who will accept this gracious invitation to become a part of the family of God, the kingdom of God? The doors of the church are now open. Let us bow for a word of prayer. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Thank you, Lord, for the many wonderful blessings you have bestowed upon all of us, your people, your children. Thank you, Lord, for healing us in our sickness. Thank you, Lord, for comforting us in our sorrow. Thank you, Lord, for forgiving us of our sins. Thank you, Lord, for strengthening us in our weakness. Thank you, Lord, for guiding and enlightening us in our confusion. Thank you, Lord, for providing for all of our needs. Thank you, Lord, for your divine benefit plan that you extend to all of your children. Thank you, O God, for all the gracious gifts you have bestowed upon us. Lord, please continue to help us to put all of our hope, all of our faith, and all of our trust in you. Lord God, we thank you and we praise you for having brought our brother, Brother John Fennell, through surgery. Lord God, thank you for allowing him to return home. Thank you, O God, for being with your people, Lord God. Thank you for protecting our sister, Samaya, who was in a very bad motor vehicle accident. But we give God thanks, Lord. We give you thanks and we give you praise that while the vehicle was torn up, that Samaya was not torn up. Lord, we thank you and we praise you for your divine protection. Lord, we thank you and we praise you for the many blessings you have bestowed upon all of us. Lord, I continue to give you thanks and give you praise for my wife's praise report and the report that she received in the follow-up visit to the surgeon's office. Lord, thank you, Lord, for the many blessings you've bestowed upon each and every one of us. Thank you, Lord, for your traveling mercies every time we travel up and down the dangerous highways. Lord, thank you, Lord, for the blessings you've bestowed upon all of your children. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of your son, Jesus, who established his church upon a rock and said in the word, upon this rock, I will build my church and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. Thank you, Lord, for this body of believers known as the Russell Temple Christian Methodist Episcopal Church. Lord, thank you for this wonderful congregation. Lord, thank you for this entire gathered worshiping community this afternoon. Lord, thank you, Lord, for allowing us this and every opportunity to worship you in spirit and in truth. Lord, I pray that you bless every precious soul assembled within the sound of my voice. I pray, oh God, that you bless every household and every family represented by the worshipers in this gathered community. Lord God, I pray that you bless every family and every household represented by all the members of this church family. Lord, thank you for all of our friends who are worshiping with us from other churches. Lord God, thank you, Lord, for all of our visitors and friends, our guests who thought it not proper to worship with us. And oh Lord, our God, we pray that you will continue to help us to hold steadfast to our faith. And Lord, according to the promise of your holy word, we pray that you will continue to supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. In the precious name of Jesus, our Christ, we pray. Amen.
It's like you're looking through a telescope. You see where you're gonna be. Growing, getting better. You're not the person they see. Can't be mad at the things you've been through, 'cause they built your muscle. Now you're stronger than you've ever been. They can't stop your hustle. Your faith ain't never small. That's what brought you this far. Oh, yeah. See, you got your dreams and you got your prayers and you got your God. He gonna take you there. See, everybody has a season, and I believe this one's yours. 'Cause you've been
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Come on, give God some more praise this afternoon. Amen. It's your time. Go get your blessing. Hallelujah. Amen. God's got a blessing with your name on it. Amen. Amen. We give God praise for another wonderful worship experience. Thank you, Reverend Wynn, for leading us in our worship today. Always a bundle of energy. Amen. We appreciate the energy and enthusiasm and exuberance that you bring to leading God's people in worship. The psalmist says, serve the Lord with gladness. Isn't that right? I really do believe people ought to be excited about serving the Lord. Isn't that right? You know, if you, somebody ought to know that you're glad about serving the Lord besides you and the Lord. Isn't that right? Somebody ought to be able to see the excitement. Isn't that right? Somebody ought to be able to see the enthusiasm. Isn't that right? Somebody ought to be able to see the exuberance. Isn't that right? Somebody ought to have some passion. Isn't that right? I know when I used to try to be a football player, you know, they used to always talk about you, even when you weren't in the game, they talk about having some chatter on the sidelines. Isn't that right? and those of you who know a little bit about the game of football, you know, there's a certain way you're supposed to come out the huddle. You know, when you break the huddle, you know, you go, you know, you break the huddle with some excitement, you know, like you're ready to get to that next play and knock heads a little bit. Isn't that right? You ought to be excited about what you do for the Lord. Amen. But we appreciate God's people who bring energy to serving the Lord. Thank you so much, Brother George Hardy, for that passionate, heartfelt prayer. Sister Tiffany Carey for the reading of the psalm. Amen. We thank all of you for passion. Amen. We give God thanks and praise for our contemporary choir. Amen. God, praise God for our contemporary choir. Amen. It was just Sister LaShawn and Brother Lamario this time, but you know what? They put it down. Isn't that right? And Brother Larry provided some vocals to go along with the music. Isn't that right? You know, and sometimes we can get so caught up in numbers that we forget. See, when you only have like 2, 3, 4, 5 voices, you know, some if those 2, 3, or 4, or 5 people, you know, have some passion, they can sound better than 25 or 30 voice choir. Come on, somebody. Isn't that right? Now, I already preached once. I ain't going to preach again. But thank you so much, Brother Larry, and goodbye, and Contemporary Choir. Thank you all so much. We appreciate it. Thank you, our amazing tech team. To God be the glory. Amen. Thank you so much. Awesome tech team. We appreciate you. Thank you so much, worshiping congregation, gathered community. A commercial first, then a hallelujah praise report. excuse me. The commercial is for our district planning meeting. Y'all saw the slide on the screen this week. Thank you, Russell Temple folk who've already registered to participate with us. But we cordially invite others to be a part of it on this coming Saturday morning. From the time frame is from 10 o'clock until 12:30. On Zoom. We try to be intentional when we have our district planning meetings and district training meetings and our district conference. We try to be intentional about sharing training that will bless the local church if folk take it back and share the information. So on this Saturday morning, we're going to have a presentation on the Vibrant Church Initiative. The Vibrant Church Initiative. Amen. The catchphrase is catch the vibe. We want folk to catch the vibe. Isn't that right? We want every congregation to be intentional about striving to make itself a more vibrant church, a more vibrant congregation in building the kingdom of God. So you're going to hear those facets of the strategic plan for the CME church. The presenter for that will be an anointed man of God, Reverend Dr. Juliano Andujo of the Miles Memorial Church in Washington, D.C. Dr. Andujo is a gifted and anointed preacher, teacher, and presenter. Amen. You will be blessed. Amen. I wouldn't be surprised if there was a little preaching with a little hoop in that presenting. Amen. But you're in for a treat as Dr. Andujo presents that plan on Saturday. And then this year, we had a few new delegates to the general conference. So we have two of our first-time members of the delegation. Matter of fact, both of them happen to be women. Amen. Two young women. A delegation presenter will be Sister Janelle Alexander from St. John. And our clergy presenter will be the Reverend Caray Y. Patterson from the Lane Memorial Church. They'll be presenting on their experience from this year's general conference. So we invite you to join us. And, you know, we start on time and we end on time. So we ain't going to take up all day. You know, we're gonna work within that 2.5 hours. And let you go your way. So we invite you to join us and to be a part of us. Now, beloved, for the praise report, amen. For the praise, actually two praise reports. And you heard me mention both of them in the prayer. When we gathered, first we gathered on Wednesday evening for the, reopening plan, which reminds me the next meeting of that will be, next reopening task force meeting will be Wednesday, August the 31st at 7 o'clock. But as we joined the other day, Brother Jeff informed us that Samaya traveling down, you know, back at school, she was involved in an accident. And when we asked him how Samaya was doing, he said, she's doing a lot better than the car is doing. Amen. God is an awesome God. Isn't that right? Because even if your car is total, you can replace a total car with insurance, but you can't replace a loved one. Isn't that right? You can replace the car, but you can't replace Samaya. Isn't that right? To God be the glory for sparing her from serious injury. Isn't that right? To God be the glory for sparing her from loss of life. Isn't that right? God be the glory for sparing her from disability. It could have been a lot worse. Isn't that right? It could have gone another way, but God had his own plan. Isn't that right? God had a part. See, that's another part, that divine benefit package is protection. Amen. I didn't list that during the sermon, but God is an awesome God. Isn't that right? And we are so grateful and so thankful for that. That's a praise report. Amen. I know Grandma Wanda and Daddy Jeff are shouting hallelujah, but the rest of the church family ought to shout hallelujah too. Isn't that right? Somebody else ought to put some claps in the chat. Somebody else ought to put some raised hands of praise in the chat. Amen. Somebody else ought to put a hallelujah in the chat. I see an amen with a whole bunch of exclamation points in the chat. Amen. God is an awesome God. We also mentioned Brother Fennell. He called early one morning to say that he was about to go in for a procedure. And when he first went into the procedure, they were planning on keeping him in the hospital for a week. Amen. I was able to go and have a nice visit with him on Friday evening. But late Saturday evening, last night, he texted me to let me know he was home. When I went to see him, he said they were talking about him going home the next day. And sure enough, late last night, the Lord brought him home. That's some more praise. Somebody ought to put another hallelujah. I see it in the chat. Put another hallelujah in the chat. God is still in the blessing business. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Hallelujah. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. Everybody have a wonderfully blessed week. Good Lord willing, we'll see you Saturday morning at the planning meeting, and Sunday morning for church school, and next Sunday afternoon for worship, if the Lord is willing. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. I think we're ready for the doxology and the benediction. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost, bless, preserve, and keep you now and forevermore. Let the church say, amen.